Hi everyone, so this is a project that I am developing with two colleagues of mine for university. It will be a third-person action game. I know that it is a very brief explanation. I will explain the game better later on. But for now, I will be focusing on the programming, the movement, combat and aiming system. I'm counting on making at least 3 devlogs for this game, so we only have 3 months to make a vertical slice, which is just like a small demo of the game. So if you would like to accompany me on this little journey, please subscribe. It would help me a lot. Enough with the boring part. I started by making a floor and some platforms. This will act like a playground so I can test stuff. I already have some stuff on this project. This is just a recreation of what we already did so far. The character and animations that we use here, we got from Mixam. For this part of the project, I am more focusing on the code and making stuff work. When we actually start building the game, we will do it on a separate project. For the code, we started with the basic, which is making the character and camera move. For the camera, we used Cinemachine, which is an easy way for making a third-person camera. We also are using the new Unity input system, and the game will be developed to be played by a controller and not the mouse and keyboard. But that doesn't mean that you cannot use the mouse and keyboard to play the game. Before making the code for the character movement, we also made a very awful animator to control the character's animation. This animator is just a placeholder and doesn't have blend trees because for now it is not a priority. Next, we made the movement script and triggered the animations. We also made the double jump code and the scriptable object to store the player variables. So now the player can move the character and the camera and also jump. I also added a particle effect to the double jump just for fun. The movement is also sensible to the controller analog. The more you push the analog, the faster the character moves. It looks weird because the animations are not correct. I need to have a blend tree between the walk and the run animation for that to work. But for now, I am only focusing on the code. Having the movement done, I added an enemy to start working on the combat and targeting system. For that, I started by making an aiming script. When the player aims at the target, it locks the aim and the field of view is altered. It looks like this. There is no point in aiming if you can't shoot. So I made some code that allows the player to shoot. And yet again, there is no point to shoot if you cannot kill the enemy. But let's make this a fair fight and make some code so the enemy can shoot at us too. Yeah, still not a fair fight. For that we need to give the player a life bar and make the code for it. Yes, I know, the number on the life bar is not correct. The number 20 should be on the right side. But I didn't notice that and the enemy rotation is all buggy too. But I will fix that later on this video. Next, we added some variations to the enemy attacks. We ended up with 3 types of attacks. For now, that's enough, but later we will make more variations. You probably already reached the conclusion that hitting an enemy is easy. That's because the difficulty in combat will be in avoiding the enemy attacks and not dying. We also made it possible to switch between enemies when aiming. this wasn't easy to make because we needed to have a lot of considerations. For example, if there is an object between the target and the player. At this point, I got bored of coding and decided to make some 3D modeling. I made this book stand in Maya, made a high poly and a low poly, and assigned some colors to use color selection in Substance Painter, and separated the object. I do not have a time lapse of doing this because I forgot to record the screen. Great. But the final result looks like this. We also went to the asset store to find some assets for vegetation and found this cool asset pack, link in the description. As I said, the project is in a very experimental and testing phase. That's why this playground looks like a mess. I also imported the book stand and add an animation to it that is triggered by code when the player gets near to it. This will be used as some kind of buy station or skill point station, but I shouldn't be focusing on this now. This was only to take my mind off coding and maths for a time. So, back to coding and maths. Now I'm trying to fix the enemy rotation problem. The thing about coding is that whatever you do, it will never work at first try. Okay, this problem seems to be solved for now. The only thing left to do now is to make the enemy look at you only at a certain range. It seems to be working for now. Okay, let's fix the number on the life bar. This is a simple fix and fast fix. Just need to put the number on the right side and there you go. Only thing left to do is to make a really bad commit to the repository, yeah, cause I forgot to commit a lot of stuff. But as I said, we will make a new project to build the game, so that's not a problem. I also improved the aiming system. Until now, to lock the aim, you needed to have the red dot on top of an enemy. So I added that green dot. Basically, it selects the enemy which is closest to the center of the screen. And when the player aims, it aims at that enemy. It wasn't easy to understand how to make this, but once I understood the maths behind it, converting world space to screen space, it was easy to program. For now, that's all that we have. There are still some improvements to make to this aiming system and bugs to fix. Don't forget to like the video and subscribe if you want to follow this little journey. It would help me a lot. Hope you liked the video. Bye.